Hello again. People often ask me, should I take up Wuzuquan if I want to learn self-defense? And my answer is a qualified no. Yes, you can learn to defend yourself using Wuzuquan, but not in the short term, not in 6 to 12 months. And even if you train for years, you may still not learn to defend yourself, because that's largely up to what you put into it. And that's true for any martial art or combat sport. Now, if you want to learn to defend yourself in 6 to 12 months, then there are different recommendations I would make depending on whether you're a man or a woman. If you're a man, you need to take up something that will teach you the basics of how to stand, how to hold a guard, how to throw a few basic strikes. Why? Because if you're attacked, you're most likely to get punched. So you need to get used to the physical, psychological, and even emotional shock of getting hit. And the biggest challenge for you will be dealing with that shock. And if you're afraid to get hit in your training, you are just psychologically not ready to be able to defend yourself. And to quote the novel Dune, fear is the mind killer. So you need to be able to handle getting hit. And boxing, sanda, muay thai, MMA, combat sports like that, will teach you that in the short term, if you're willing to get hit. If you're a woman, you're more likely to be attacked by someone you know than by a total stranger. And for young women in particular, that assault is likely to come in the form of a boyfriend or date who does not understand or refuses to understand the word no. Now, assuming your partner's a man, it's very unlikely that you'd be able to overcome him with brute force. So you need to study something that will teach you to redirect force, to control, to suppress, and even knock out a larger opponent without having to resort to brute force. You also need to take up something that will have you under pressure within weeks of starting, so you get used to that psychological and emotional stress. And Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu ticks those boxes. Not just because of the techniques that it teaches, but also because within weeks you'll be on the mat grappling with somebody. Of course, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu will not prepare you for every situation that you might encounter, but it will prepare you for the most likely ones. If you're a man, the irony of taking up martial arts or combat sports for self-defense is that your fear of being attacked is way out of proportion to the risk of you actually being attacked. And the likelihood that you'll be injured in training is far greater than the likelihood you'll ever be attacked. But because you fear the latter, you embrace the former, and you inflict on yourself the kind of injuries that you don't want an assailant to inflict on you. And I speak from experience. It's different for women. Misogyny is all too real and all too common. I know, not all men, blah, 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 but enough men, too many men. According to the World Health Organization, 1 in 3 women worldwide experiences violence. So for women, the fear of violence is justified. So why do I recommend stand-up fighting for men and ground fighting for women? It's not that men should never learn ground fighting, nor that women should never learn stand-up fighting. It's that if you're a man, your attacker is likely to have friends with him. So you really don't want to be wrapped up on the ground with that one opponent when his friends are standing around ready to kick you in the head. If you're a woman, you're very unlikely to win a stand-up fight trading blows with a man. You want to take him to the ground where you can rob him of most of his strength advantage. Of course, I'm speaking in general terms of what you can learn in school in 6 to 12 months. Whatever you take up, if they don't put you under combat pressure early on, then it's not likely to be good to you for self-defense in the short term. Now, in Wuzuquan, it's not that we never put you under pressure. It's that the early stages of your training, we place great emphasis on building a foundation of technical competence with very little pressure testing. Why not? Well, if we pressure test you too soon, if we put you up against the wall and have a line of people throwing punches at you, you will fall back on what you know, which will be whatever rubbish you brought with you, and you won't build the skills and the foundation that we need you to develop. Bear in mind that Wuzuquan was a martial art, and it was developed by warriors who became monks, who literally had all day to train. Now, if you train 6 to 8 hours a day under a good Wuzuquan instructor, then you probably would learn to defend yourself in 6 to 12 months. But attending class twice a week, even if you're training in between, it's really not going to happen for you in the short term. So why don't we adjust the Wuzuquan syllabus to facilitate the quicker learning of self-defense? And I would say a lot of practitioners of traditional martial arts would say that learning to defend yourself against drunks, muggers, misogynists, whatever, is a side benefit of training and not the main purpose of it. Now, if we adjusted the syllabus to facilitate quick learning of self-defense, I think large parts of the art would be lost. Now, you might say, well, what's the point in keeping those parts if they don't facilitate quick learning of self-defense? And I would say that the art is worth practicing for its own sake. And there are other immediate benefits, such as fitness and health. And if you train properly, you will learn to defend yourself anyway in the longer term. And this is why I won't adjust the syllabus to suit people who want to learn self-defense quickly. Instead, I will happily refer them to other schools. So does that mean Wuzuquan is not really good for self-defense? Well, of course it is. It's a combat system that was developed over centuries by warriors who had to fight and stay alive in feudal China. Dealing with drunken brawlers was the least of their worries. But put that aside for a moment. There's really only one reason why you should take up Wuzuquan. You've seen it. You like the look of it. You think you'll enjoy practicing it. That's it. But do choose a school where they're going to put you under pressure at some point. That might start with putting you up against the wall, lining up the class to throw punches and kicks at you. You've got to stand there and deal with that or get whacked. Moving on to light sparring and heavy sparring. Unfortunately, there are a lot of Wuzuquan practitioners who are not willing to do that, but that's for another discussion. Visit a class. Make sure you get to see senior training sessions and not just beginners. Ask about pressure testing. Ask about the likelihood of getting hurt. It's a trick question. If they say there's no risk, walk away. Because either they're lying to you or they will never properly pressure test you. Thanks for watching.